Oh, I didn't see you there. Despite the best efforts of its own writing, Neon Genesis Evangelion has become one of the most merchandised media properties of all time. Somehow, this existentialist musing on the nature of trauma has been used to sell everything from luxury fashion, shaving razors, buckets, credit cards, and even toilets. Today, we will not be focusing on such perversions of this masterwork, and instead, we'll be taking a look at an Ava-branded product that does actually make some effort in engaging with the show on a thematically and aesthetically congruous level. A piece of media that, just like Evangelion, was created by a young, boundary-pushing group of industry newcomers, and that sits in engaging conversation with the rest of NGE's multimedia retellings and interpretations. This is Evangelion New Theatrical Rhythm Sound Impact. Before we get on with it, please like this video, comment down below, and subscribe to the Any Button to Start channel. Anyway, let's go. The idea of an Ava rhythm game fits right in with the overly merchandised nature of late game Evangelion fandom and exploitation. So, this Japan-exclusive PSP title, released to coincide with the second rebuild film, should have, by all metrics, been a cash grab that faded from existence soon after birth. However, by some crazy piece of lost development lore... Oh, actually, don't worry, I just checked and it wasn't lost, it was just in Japanese. Anyway, this game was developed by none other than cult favourite director Goichi Suda, better known as Suda51, and his very own development studio, Grasshopper Manufacture. This oddball team of Japanese developers were responsible for some of the most stylish and memorable games of the past two decades, including The Silver Case, Flower Sun and Rain, Killer 7, Contact, and No More Heroes. So the idea of these experimental creatives obtaining the rights to adapt one of the most boundary-pushing anime of all time explains why this game has gained a quiet cult following around the world since its release. If I were to dig into it a little more, I could even draw parallels between Grasshopper and Evangelion's original production studio, Gainax. They were both born from separate experimental renaissances in their respective mediums industries, and both were led by creatives obsessed with the existential. Grasshopper, on paper, were really the best people to be making an Ava game. But I wouldn't be making this video if it was just on paper, so let's look at how they did. New Theatrical Edition will take the player through a bullet point summary of the plots of the first two rebuild films. However, if you have not seen those movies, do not expect to get sufficient context for what you're witnessing about half of the time. Yes, because of the lack of English subtitles or voice acting, though more likely due to the fact that Sound Impact takes an abstract approach to letting the player inhabit the world of Evangelion. You see, if you ask me, Neon Genesis Evangelion is a show and franchise of two halves, those being the straightforward action robot fighting parts, and then the more subtle, quiet, and occasionally abstract moments of characters dealing with trauma and navigating the hostile social environment of Nerv. At the show's and rebuild movie's starts, these elements feel separated for the most part. But as the story and its characters descend further into darkness, this abstractness bleeds into every facet of its presentation and narrative, eventually leading to the show's controversially stark and unceremonious final few episodes. Most game adaptations of Ava stick firmly within the fan-safe territory of those early episodes, choosing to allow players the thrill of piloting the show's robots or even engaging with more light-hearted character moments, though never allowing it to get any deeper. If you were to only know NGE through its games, I wouldn't blame you for assuming its story was a lot more vapid than it actually becomes. Neon Genesis Evangelion New Theatrical Edition Sound Impact rejects the assertion that Ava games have to be about fighting or fan service, and instead directly pulls from the abstract nature of the show, making it feel like an actual part of the extended multimedia Evangelion timeline instead of just a cash grab. Let me explain myself with all of this talk of abstractness. The game does, as stated earlier, walk you through the events of the NGE plot up to a certain point. That much is to be expected from Ava games. Where Sound Impact differs is in the mechanics with which the player interacts with those plot events. The game has six different rhythm-based minigames which it shuffles through to represent different types of moments within the story. An angel's initial attack is portrayed through a call and response type game, where the higher the player's combo gets, the more ammo they have to take it out at the end of the round. More scrappish fights between Ava unit and angel are met by these hexagonal rhythm games, which are the hardest in the game to match the frenzied nature of the fights behind them. Character introductions and subtler moments have two similar minigames where the background is revealed slowly as you play. There are also these brilliant, almost proto-endless runner-type sections for the chase sequences, and finally, one that reminds me visually of Thumper, which is sort of just used randomly. Somehow, these six minigames come together over 30 music tracks remixed from the original show and movies to create an experience truer to the original spirit of the series than any of the more mechanically faithful adaptations that I have played. These minigames, with their focus on rhythm action, force the player to physically reckon with one of Evangelion's most pervasive themes, synchronization. When a player catches the beat of one of the game's songs and hits the buttons totally in sync without a thought, the game has achieved its goal of emulating the feeling of piloting an Ava unit. A large part of the show's plot and theming revolves around the characters syncing with each other and their units, both emotionally and physically. So, if any of us were paying attention, we would have realized how suited Ava is to a rhythm game. I mean, a whole episode is spent watching Shinji and Asuka play DDR so they can sync up and perform a violent dance to take out an angel. This game can also slow down as the show does, and during the more character-oriented minigames, the use of seemingly random voice clips and stills from the movies reminded me a lot of the collage-like presentation of episodes 25 and 26 of the original show. Suda51 and his team saw right through the aesthetical artifice at the forefront of Evangelion's public perception, to craft a piece that does not echo the show, but instead stands in conversation with it. The variety of its minigames reflects the diversity of tones and themes present within the best pieces of Evangelion media. Grasshopper was clearly not willing to phone this one in, and out of all the NGE spin-offs not made by Gainax or Hideki Anno, their game is the one that seems to understand the franchise's original ethos and intent the most. New Theatrical Edition Sound Impact is the perfect companion piece for Neon Genesis Evangelion. And I mean, you gotta hear all that sweet, sweet music. Thank you for getting to the end of this video, dear viewer. Before you go, please like the video and comment any thoughts you had down below. And if you're feeling generous, hit the subscribe button, as we're on the road to hitting 2,000 subscribers, and we could really use your help. Anyway, hope you enjoyed it, and until next time.